I would like to show you how you can compile C program using free Visual Studio. First, you have to download it, then you have to install it, and finally you have to configure it to make it working. To install Visual Studio, you can type free Visual Studio, and the first result should be the right one. If you open the web page, you can see Visual Studio Community. There is a free download button. If you click on it, in a moment the download will start. You have to run the installer being presented. After accepting elevation of your privileges, you have to click continue, and then you will have to wait a couple of minutes. It will take some time to install all features. Of course, you can pick your features. You can select your features to be installed. You do not have to install every single Visual Studio functionality. For us, the thing which we will need is a desktop development with C++. If I click on it, automatically the set of features being used for this purpose is selected, and you can see the space is 8 GB, which is a lot, but at the same time it will provide you a complete environment for compiling your C applications. After clicking install, the installation starts. And at the same time, by default, it is downloaded and installed in the background. Now we have wait a couple of minutes before it is installed. After a couple of minutes, it reaches 99%, and I will uncheck I didn't uncheck, but you have a possibility to uncheck launching it. I'm not signing to Visual Studio. I can do this later. I will leave the default colors theme and etc. You can change it later as well. And I will start Visual Studio. It is being prepared for the first usage. I do not like launching application from the installer. I'm never really sure about the token, etc. So I will close it, I will close the installer, and I will launch the Visual Studio the standard way. So here you can see it in your start menu, and if I click on Visual Studio 2019, Visual Studio starts. The very first question here, you can see it is empty, it is fresh, is about what you want to do. You want to create a new project. Now you have a question about a type of the project. So about language, about the platform, about the purpose, and so on. Let's start with the simplest example, which is a console application. You can see there is no C as a language. There is only C++. Visual Studio detects if it's C or C++ based on the file source file extension, but we will use C++. When the Visual Studio says C++, we can use C inside as well. So I will pick console up, I will click next, I will put some name, test one, I will place solution and project in the same directory. It will simplify the directory structure for the project, for my application. And here comes the default location, which is my profile, then source, then repos. You can change it, of course. You can change the defaults as well. After I click create, the empty project will open. It will use the default settings for this type of the project. You can create your own default settings, but it is way out of scope. So here you can see a piece of code. You can clearly see it is C++ and not C. So if I want to compile C program, I have to change my file, my source file name from CPP to C. F2, like in Explorer, C, enter, and now you can see that the application is in C, which means the C++ syntax not valid. If I want to make it C, the same way for C would be, instead of IOStream, I will remove this comment. Instead of IOStream, I will include stdio.h. Within stdio.h, I have printf. For printf, I can, of course, use hello world. And that's basically the code I want to write. I will remove the rest of the comment, and my first C program is ready to compile. And now I have to pick a configuration for my solution and the platform. I can compile it x64 to make it 64-bit, and debug means the debugging information allowing me to run it within Visual Studio, debugging it later and so on, will be created. They will be slightly different set of libraries, there will be PDB files created and so on. If you want to test your application, you can use debug, it makes a lot of sense. If you want to distribute your application, probably you have to change it to release. Right now we are using release for x64 with default configuration. This default configuration is not perfect and I highly recommend changing it. If I compile my application, it's under build and build or just Control B, you will see messages coming here and you will see the result of the build and the path to the executable file which is created within the solution directory. I will run my cmd, I do dir, and I will paste my path. You can see the file is very small, and it is not good it is small because it relies on runtime libraries, so it is not portable. If you move this .exe file into some computer where Visual Studio runtime, Visual Studio is not installed, or Visual C runtime is not installed, this application will simply not run. Right here you can easily run it and it works because we have all those libraries. So I definitely recommend changing the configuration in a way which makes the Visual Studio creating executable file which is fully portable. To do so, you have to change the configuration of the Visual Studio. So you can go to project, then project properties, the name is test1, so test1 properties, and here you can go to C, and under code generation you can find a runtime library, which is here. And by default, it is MD. It is not clearly described here, but MD means please use runtime libraries. MT means please link them into the executable file. So I will click OK. I will build my project again. My file is being created. If I do the same dir again, you can see the size is significantly bigger. Of course, the application still works, and right now it is fully portable. So this is the first change I recommend before you try to release, before you try to distribute your executable file. Another thing I highly recommend is information about PDB files, because by default debug information is not included into the within the release version, but the information about the location of the PDB file is included. So I will run sysinternals tool called strings. I will try to look for long strings, and then I will include the path. And after displaying long strings included in within the executable file, you can see there is a path to the PDB exposing the place where the project is located on my drive. And in most cases, you do not want to distribute executable file containing this information inside due to different reasons. To change this behavior, again, test one properties, and then you have to go to linker, and then debugging, and then debug info. You switch to none. No. Okay. If you go to build test one, the new executable file is being created. I will reissue the same command looking for long strings, and there is no information about the path anymore. And obviously, the code, it is fully working, etc. Right now, you can put your C source code taken from anywhere. Let's take it from my GitHub repo. Control A, Control C, Control A, Control V, Control B. Well, I have comments at the beginning which are definitely wrong. I know this is the stuff here. So Control B again, and .exe file is ready to be distributed. That's basically it. So you can see you can install and configure free Visual Studio and start compiling your C source code quickly and relatively easily. Thanks a lot.